Hello, this is Tess, and this time I'm going to attempt to solo Heroic Elite Shroud. This will be my very first time attempting to solo it. I have a few ideas about how to do it the best, but since I've never done it, we'll see how it goes. I do need smiting arrows. Also, it's been probably a month since I ran this character last, so we'll see. Since I'm way over level, I'm expecting this to be semi-easy, but might not be. Okay, first portal. Oh, I went the wrong way, huh. No, I didn't. We usually do this one first, over there. Then we'll do this one, and then another one is going to spawn here to the right. had to double check that I wasn't running another difficulty. So I don't remember if I've run this life. And I... Okay, I'd turned off my bravery, so... I probably wouldn't die anyway in this one since I'm way over level. I wonder if I forgot one. Didn't.
Another Eldritch device sits here. This one is distinctly different from the one in Meridia.
I'm done with portals, I shouldn't need smiting right now. This corner where I was is usually where we pull everything. The bosses are immune to harm when they're next to each other, but it's only the first time. So my plan is to try and kill them all once. Then once they're dead, I can prep them. I mean, once they respawn. Seems I might have been wrong. dying quite easily. I just need to get all of them far away. Hopefully get them down at the same time. Missing the gnome. I should have killed him. He's not dying. Pull them away again. Oops. Yes, I'm very much messing this up. Oh crap. He died again. Well, these guys are well prepped. Cat is gonna be difficult to beat. Cat has to die last. Now I run my ass off. And I got it done.
The hold over the shrine breaks with it. The path to the altar of the new moons is open. The altar of the new moons awaits.
I'm gonna shrine, even though I probably don't need to. For the next phase, I'm going to skip doing the puzzles. I'm only gonna do the first one, or am I even gonna do that? Probably need to do one to get out. Then I'm gonna break them. So I won't have time to do all the puzzles before the rainbow shows up. This basically means I'm missing out on the optional chests, but like I said, I'm soloing, I won't have time to do all the puzzles, so.
In this picture, you gather a vial of lunar dew from the marble fountain.
Okay. could unlock them too, but since I'm not a trapper and I would have to use bells to do it, it's faster for me to just break the crystals. At least I have a character run somewhat quickly. Rainbow might be coming up soon. Rainbow's up. You have to go the other way. I just have to make sure I don't run into it. It's in the corner somewhere. There it is. The 5x5 in the north. I left to do. I will follow the rainbow. I just have to make sure I don't run into it in the corner because it turns kind of funny in corners. If that thing touches me, I'm dead, and it's game over. Only safe spot from it is here in center.
Fountain bubbles to life. The magical barrier to the altar of the waxing moons dissipates.
Rainbow should be gone now.
The portal to the challenge of the full moons shimmers into existence. A small devil scouting force.
blade select the most difficult here for me. I was hoping I would have enough DPS to take him out, but nope, I was wrong. I mean, in one go. Yay.
Sana's voice echoed.
Yay. One shard of power.
Last moon will be traumatic. Do not abandon your quest yet. Trust in the shroud.
What is this? Why am I here? I should be on Shavaroth. What is this trickery?
Eretricus roars at his imprisonment.
You have done this! You and those pitiful lodgers, my wrath will burn all of Zendrick. Destroy them, my lieutenants, while I bask in the power of the eclipse.
As the crystal shatters, the lieutenants of Shavaroth return to battle. Eretricus floats above, so we gain the power of the eclipse moons.
Thank you.
rage rub. There we go.
Explodes. The altar of the lost moon flares to life, pulling the final lunar body into perfect eclipse. Lemania will rightfully be manifest with the veil of twilight.
Okie dokie.